Hi, welcome. This is Dr. John DeMartini. This is one of the most amazing and inspiring shows that you can listen into. If you want to be on the edge of your seats, if you want to open up your heart, if you want to expand your mind, and you want to meet incredible people, stay tuned because you're just about to experience a transformative radio show that will change your life. And you're listening to the Dr. Pat Show is coming up right next.
The following audio is via a Skype call.
Welcome to the Dr. Pat Show, talk radio to thrive by. Powerful, inspiring, and coming to you live, bringing you stories of people like you and me, busting through and living life full out. Get ready to dare to wonder what your life would be like if you knew you could not fail. Hey, everyone. I'm Dr. Pat. Welcome to the Dr. Pat Show. We have got a fabulous, fabulous show for you today. 2 hours of it, actually. You know, along the way, I had gone on a healing journey. In 2004, I came down with, well, let's just call it a mystery disease. But what did I learn along the way? Well, I've learned many, many things, and you've heard me talk about them. But I'll tell you the thing I was most resistant about, and that was about water. Because if you're like me, you're thinking to yourself, really, what are the benefits of water? How do they work? Well, here's what we're going to share with you today. I'm thrilled to have both Dan and Karen joining me here today, but Dan Edlund and Karen Cash. And the reason I've asked them and a host of other folks to join us here today is because people have asked, what can we do? How can we do it? And is it going to make a difference? So this is the first of a series that we will be doing to talk about the benefits of how to take and become empowered in your own life. Understanding the benefits of proper hydration for optimal health is something that I poo-pooed for years, but I'm here to tell you I've changed my mind. Today we're going to talk about what alkaline water is. What does it mean, and what are the properties that are added to water now that we are now finding more and more about? And did you know that there are studies, research that is being done all over the world to say, wait a minute, you can learn something about the water that you're putting in your system. But let me just talk about something else. You know, if you live in the state of Washington or anywhere near what's going on here, you think that Washington State would be the last state on the planet where we would have water that is coming through our faucets, which we look at and say, oh my gosh, is that really coming through there? So I began to get on a mission. And so part of the mission that I'm on is getting at the bottom of things. And what I've discovered is that the benefits of understanding about water and what we put into our bodies is profound. The other thing that we will share with you today is how does this understanding equate to optimal health? You know, what is it that I did on my journey, investigation, that's brought me to this place today? I am a researcher by nature. I am a skeptic. And so I generally don't talk about things on the show that I'm not willing to put my name behind or to demonstrate the benefits of. Today, I want to share a profound story with you about, let's just call it water until Dan and Karen come on. Now, why is it that I'm talking with you about this? Well, many of you have heard me talk about my healing journey, but I will tell you this. It has been a journey that has taken many, many faces. But today, I can tell you that I've made literally two changes in my life in the past 6 or 8 weeks. And one of them is to infuse my body with water that I didn't believe would make a difference. And what's changed as a result of that? You're going to hear from me today talk about some things that have changed in terms of my own blood work and much more. And how do we know this actually works? You know, this is really where you have to go and look at what people are saying in the world. You know, what is it that studies now are coming out to try to say or not say? You know, what is it that we want to hear more about? What's the relationship between cancer, Lyme disease, and alkaline water? Today, fasten your seatbelts. Lots to share. I am so thrilled to be introducing you to two people that have made it their business to understand the difference between alkaline, alkaline ionized water, a lot of strange names to things, but the point to all of this is it going to make a difference? Dan, of course, Karen, of course, you know, Dan has a hydration specialist. He's passionate about this. And he has been helping people understand that their lives can change. He's dedicated his life to informing others on the many benefits of electrolyzed reduced water and sharing, you know, this Japanese technology. He does this one family at a time. He goes home to home and, as a matter of fact, came to my home and said, listen, just try it. See if it works. Karen has been worked as a personal in-home caretaker for more than a dozen years. Compassion for others is an understatement. First introduced to, you know, what the water that we're going to talk about today by a naturopath and watched as it literally transformed the life of a very sick loved one. You're going to hear her story as well. Since then, she's learned that all she can about this particular water and how it is now available for everyone out there. Today's show is transformative in many, many ways. For those of you listening to the audio version of it, here's what I want to say. You know, you're going to hear a lot of it. It's a two-hour segment. For those of you that are watching through the camera here in the studio, and if you're not, I'm going to let you know how to do that. You're going to watch some on-air demonstrations. For those of you that may be listening to the video version of this that we wanted to show you and demonstrate to all of you, you're getting to watch this real time. Many, many things are going to come up in your mind. Does it really work? Can it work for me? What can I expect? And by the way, antioxidants, what has that got to do with water anyway? So how did it all begin? Well, let's talk about this. In the 1950s, scientific research was conducted at several unique locations around the world. For thousands of years, these places have maintained legendary status as natural source of mineral water. You know, we've heard mineral water over and over and over again. It was discovered that the miracle healing water, all of these locations had one thing in common, an abundance of active hydrogen. That today is known as alkaline water. Now, what does this mean? How do you get to the place where you're talking about alkaline water? But somewhere out of the range of things, a company emerges. Now, what does this company have to have? It has to have somebody that has vision, that has insight, that believes in quality. And you're going to hear about that as we move forward today. Because it's not just one thing to have alkaline ionized water. It's not. It's like, who is it that's providing it? Dr. Darvish and I have done many, many things over the years where we've talked to so many different people that have so many solutions for things. But today's show is really different because I really had to see things for myself. I had to know that this is something that was going to make a difference in my life. What is it that is so mind-boggling to so many people? Well, in 1965, the Japanese Health and Welfare Agency approved electrolysis water devices. And so why did they do that? What's going on in Japan? Why is this such an easy conversation to have in the Japanese culture about water? Is it because, you know, there's something that they've learned over time? Well, you're going to hear about that. Today, I am so thrilled to be talking with Dan and with Karen. Now, I was approached 10 years ago to talk about water, but I'm telling you, I was a skeptic. And I really, really didn't fully understand what it was going to do to help me. But if I go back 10 years ago, I was in the middle of my own health crisis and didn't really understand or know how to deal with what was going on. Whether you're worried about the level of inflammation in your system, whether you're worried about whether you're antioxidants are working. Today we want to take you on a journey, not just to talk about this, but to demonstrate this. You're going to see some demonstrations on the camera that when I saw them, I was shocked. But beyond those demonstrations, I want to hear from people that have actually had experiences that have changed their lives, have changed their bodies. You know, all of us are going to get older. I'm dealing with a little bit of that myself. But what is it about becoming this absolutely youthful state of being, no matter what age you are, that's important? Because right now what we are learning is that age is not really a factor in our health conditions. Not at all. You know, we have levels of autoimmune disease that are so far on the rise, we don't even know what to do with them. You know, we're not quite sure of what food to put in our system. And by the way, if you're putting the food in there, are you sure that what you're putting in there has gotten the quality of purity that you're looking for? You know, Dan and Karen came over and did a couple of demonstrations right in my own home. And I was like, what? The other thing, though, I want to say is I did my own. Because even after being here with Dan and working with Dan, even after the benefits that I saw of the water, I had to do my own demonstration. I literally, this is what I did. You guys know me, right? This is what I did. So, you know, I took my old faucet filter that we had taken off my water faucet, and I took it off. And Dan was telling me, and of course he's going to tell you about all this, so I apologize in advance if I don't get this right, but he was telling me about the 2.5. And I thought, okay, we're not going to drink the 2.5, but we can rinse with that. We can wipe our counters with that. And as a matter of fact, we're going to share some information that hospitals in multiple countries are using this to clean things. But listen, so I thought, really, does this really work? So I took my old filter, you know, that metal filter, and I said, you know, I'm going to do an experiment because, you know, I just want to see. So I put a little bit of the 2.5 in a glass. And I put the water, and I put my little filter in there. And I left it in there. I didn't put any soap in there. I didn't put any detergent. I didn't put nothing in there, right? I didn't mix it. I didn't take a brush and scrub it. I just put it in there, and I let it sit. And I came back, and all I did was lift up the filter, and I just shook around a little bit. Now, the picture you see on the screen is from a little filter that's about, what, maybe a half an inch apart, that sat in this 2.5. My water was coming through my faucet. What you see in the bottom of this container, for those of you that can't see it, those are little black speckles that came off of my water filter by sitting in this 2.5. Now, why am I sharing that with you? Well, thanks to Dr. Darvish, I've learned a lot about health and wellness. But what I haven't been wanting to learn is about hydration. I haven't been wanting to learn that there's maybe something more that I can do. And what is the resistance? Boy, I came up with excuses that I don't want to drink bottled water. It's not good for the environment. You know, water machines are this or that. They don't work. They do work. I want to say that I'm sharing this message today because I am on a mission. I want to make sure that people have in their hands the ability to bring something into their lives which could literally change it, in some cases save it. So today you're going to hear how we're paying things forward. But most importantly, we're going to take you through a range of why this is an important conversation to have and let you decide for yourselves. Yeah, I mean, I have my own experience about it. I can talk to you about how energized I am, how much better I feel, and maybe I'll even, I don't understand it. I'm not an expert in this arena. I just want to help people save lives. If there's any of you out there that can avoid going through what I went through starting in 2004, looking at a wheelchair in 2008, and today I'm telling you I am out there and I am active and I am getting so absolutely incredibly energized about today's show. I can't wait to hear what is going to be shared. And for those of you watching the video, I'm just telling you, the stuff we're showing you, this is a live in-studio demonstration. There's nothing gimmicky about this. And I plan to continue. I took pictures of a wood, what do they call that, butcher block that I had in my kitchen. I did half of it with the 2.5. I did the other half later on. But I started to question the fact that this was really working for me. then I started to ask, am I really alone? You know, what is it that we've now learned? Well, stay tuned. We've got a great show for you guys today. If you want to call in, 1-800-930-2819. And I'm telling you, I'm on a mission. I'm really on a mission. I am hoping that we can put a machine in every home, especially for those of you out there that have people that are suffering. Let's take a short break, everyone. When we come back, more with the Dr. Pat Show, Dan, Karen, Jessica's in the house, all of you. I'm a little nervous. I got to tell you, I'm a little nervous about this show today. I'm a little nervous. You know, I just want to share something with you all. Let's take a short break. I'll be right back.
Tune in to The Jen Royster Show, intuitive guidance to inspire your life, each Thursday at 8 a.m. Pacific and 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. This amazing show is an inspirational hour that will take you on an epic metaphysical journey to discover the spiritual approach to life's greatest challenges. Dr. Jen is an internationally known intuitive counselor, spiritual teacher, and energy healer. Call in for intuitive readings and visit JenRoyster.com for more information.
Hi, I'm Tim Darter.
And I'm Steve Kramer.
Join us on Spirit Fire Radio. Discover how to add the mechanics of meditation to your day.
And watch yourself connect in a whole new way. Find the amazing moments in life's routines that often pass us by. Add to your awareness with Spirit Fire Radio.
Tune in each Wednesday at 9 a.m. for your weekly guide to practical mindfulness. And to learn more, visit www.spiritfireradio.com.
Get ready to rid yourself of all that is weighing you down and holding you back from living the life you want for yourself. Coming Clean, The Art of Transparency with Catherine Moss is a hit show for women in recovery who are ready to live life on purpose. Tune in and let Catherine help you live your truth one day at a time. Live each Tuesday, 9 a.m. Pacific on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Transformation Talk Radio is dedicated to the education and awareness of Lyme disease.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to Lyme Talk Radio. I'm Dr. Pat, joined here by
Dr. Nusheen Darvish.
Dr. Pat Basile and Dr. Nusheen Darvish will be bringing the most innovative, groundbreaking information, research, treatment innovations, and stories from those it affects every day.
I'm so excited to be talking about this.
We have so much to share.
Dr. Darvish and I are planning to do is connect the dots.
People suffering with all sorts of chronic diseases, it's time. It is time for them to transform.
Tune into Lyme Talk Radio and help keep our mission strong.
For the loyal listeners out there that have been listening to this incredible show on Lyme disease, we are not going to let you down. We're going to come through stronger and enrich the platform for Lyme disease awareness through Lyme Talk Radio. The message will continue, the conversations will become stronger, and the healing epic.
Awaken to your radiant, authentic self. For over 15 years, Soul Purpose Advocate Nancy Monson has been focused on leading change in the lives of those looking to live their true purpose. She is devoted to supporting people in living a soul-directed life every day. Let Nancy help you overcome fear, worry, and doubt. Visit everydayspirituality.com to learn how Nancy can be your Soul Purpose Advocate.
The doctor is in. Tune in to the hit show, The Psychic Love Doctor, with host Deborah Lee. Deborah's life-affirming, highly perceptive reading method has taught Deborah how to zero in on specific problems with relationships, career pursuits, and current roadblocks to success and happiness. Join Deborah Fridays at 2 p.m. Pacific and for a special broadcast the second Thursday of every month at 11 a.m. Pacific on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Mother gazing out of the window, staring at a sun.
Hey, everybody, welcome back. It's so great to be chatting with all of you. Thank you for tuning us in, turning us on. For those of you out there, you want to find out more about us, you can go to thedrpatshow.com. And I just want to just tell everybody that throughout these this show and the next hour, you can ask questions. You can call us. You've got that number, 1-800-930-2819. Or you can go to the Dr. Pat Show website and or transformationtalkradio.com. And on the right-hand side, you could type in your question. We'll get the questions on here. I'm so thrilled to be introducing you to both Dan and Karen. They're both here joining me today so that they can give you an amazing view of what they're seeing happen in the lives of other people. But also, why is this even an important conversation? Karen, Dan, welcome to the show. It's great to have you guys here.
Thank you
for having us.
Yeah. Well, let's start out with the conversation about, like, water. You know, I heard the expression water, water everywhere, but not a drop to drink. But basically, it's water, water everywhere. Wow. Be careful what you drink. That's like the new saying now about water. If you live in Washington State, you are like so going to watch the water you drink. But let's kind of start with the conversation and bring us up to date with what we've learned about water. And why is it even an important conversation, Karen?
Well, I think people need to when we look at health today, people don't realize the main key thing that people aren't focusing on anymore is the water and or the quality of water that they put into their body. And, you know, water is actually the most crucial ingredient to our health. It does almost everything for us. Water carries oxygen to our cells. It transports nutrients. It hydrates. It detoxifies. It removes waste. It cushions our joints. It keeps our organs and our tissues from drying out. It regulates our body temperature. Water does almost everything for us, but it's important to know the quality of water that we put in.
And I think that's the biggest thing is that so many people have the conversation now isn't water just water?
Yeah.
And so more than anything, what we want to do today is show with these demonstrations, and we're going to pull out three or four of the best-selling bottled waters in the world, the water that your customers or that your listeners are probably consuming on a daily basis, and they're under the impression that this water is hydrating them and doing wonderful things for them. And what we're going to show is that maybe that's not all entirely true. We're gonna do some different demos, and we're actually going to show the differences in water, and we're going to show you that all water is not created equal.
But let's talk about this for a minute, because, you know, now we're getting studies that are coming out. So let's talk about a couple of them. The latest study that I came across was really interesting because, you know, there was this university, I think it's Missouri or Minnesota or someplace, I have the information, and they decided they were going to do a study because that's what universities do. They study things. And so the one thing they picked was the one thing that's on everybody's mind, especially right now if you're thinking, I'm going to get myself in a bikini right now. You know, and that is you're coming out there and you're thinking, oh, we got to take off the pounds, got to take off the pounds. So they went and they did this study. And what they discovered is that water, period, right? And this is the first place that people start with the study, because there's no point in talking about alkaline, ionized water coming out of Tacoma right now if we are not sold on the fact that our bodies really benefits from water, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so they did this study, and it was, you know, one of these random. Bottom line is the people that were drinking the water were losing the weight. Sure. The people that were not drinking the water, and there's science around that.
Mm-hmm.
But let's talk about that. We're talking about why do we lose weight under good, ordinary conditions? Well, that means your body is working well, right?
Sure.
So even in the very foundation of what we're talking about, you've got to be looking at water to begin with. But not all water is alike, is it? Mm-hmm. And we know that. And, you know, Dan, we weren't joking, but we were looking at the headlines this morning.
Sure.
The state of Washington, of all places, I never thought here.
Right.
I'm from the East Coast, right? We know what happened back on the East Coast with all that toxic dumping, but sure. Never here.
Absolutely.
Are you shocked about that?
I'm actually not, because what I'm going to do is show you something really quick, which I've found in our water supply. And so what I did is brought a little bit of local water, and I don't think people really understand the alarming amounts of
chlorine.
So you
got it from the faucet.
I did.
You took it from the faucet.
Absolutely.
So before you do it, tell us what you're doing.
Well, what
because
I'm doing
this is
here,
gonna be fun to watch.
I have some absolutely clear drops here,
yeah.
And I've got tap water from the faucet supply here.
Yeah.
And what I'm going to do is add about three or four drops.
All right.
And what you're going to see.
What's going to happen to that?
Well, that's detecting the amount of chlorine in the current tap water
supply.
Okay,
so right now, what is that color? What's chartreuse?
It's changing.
Yellow, green, yeah, green, yellow?
Right, and the darker that it gets, the worse off it is. Now, the funny thing is,
As
we go down into downtown Seattle and do demos for homes there and show them what's in their water supply, a lot of the times that water's turning orange, which is just a severe amount of chlorine. Now, another thing is with chlorine, it's taken in through, obviously, through the shower and you know, when we wash our food and things like that. But it's absolutely known to be one of the biggest causes of asthma and cancer today.
Oh, yeah, yeah, the research on chlorine now.
Right,
yeah.
And even more harmful inhaled than it is when it's soaked up through the pores. But here I'm also giving you a
look at the color of that. That is, that, you know, that color can actually match that green wall out there that you guys heard me talk about last week, about the green out there. OMG.
And so for your bottle water drinkers out there, what I'm doing is also showing them, because they're thinking, well, I don't use this. I drink bottle water.
That's okay.
And we're going to get to that later.
I'm good with the bottle
water.
But
what I'm showing you now is three fingers in a separate glass. And what I'm going to do is now add the same chlorine drops to that water. And I want you to see what happens here, because this is, and I'm putting about five times as many drops as I did in the other one. And you see what's happening? It's not turning any kind of color. And that is how fast the human body soaks up that chlorine.
Okay, so you did the same thing, but you had your three fingers in that water.
For less than 30 seconds.
I watched you. Very good. Jessica's recording you, so yes. She's going to, we're going to make sure to keep you on up and up here, Dan.
Well, yeah, and please take a moment to look at the podcast, because that's how fast the three
Hold
fingers.
Hold on, I want to move the water. Hold on. Wow.
And you'll see this is the chlorine water. This is what I put my fingers in. But look at how much of that chlorine that I soaked in.
So tell me about putting the fingers in. What happened there? You soaked it up?
Yes.
You soaked up the chlorine in your fingers?
Absolutely.
In 30 seconds, you put that in there and it's in your fingers.
Yeah, and imagine what we do in a 10, 15-minute shower, or for the mother out there that bathes.
Oh, we're drinking it.
Or bathes a child in a bathtub. Imagine a child in a bathtub for 15, 20 minutes.
Now you're getting to the scary stuff right here.
And that's what we want to do, is inform people.
I never
because,
really thought about the baby thing.
Right? That's the biggest thing with mothers. If I go out and show them what's in their water and we start talking about their children taking baths at night, they want this
Why did
technology.
You guys get, I mean, I got to ask you, because I'm always interested in it. You heard me share like a little bit of why, you know, I changed the whole landscape of the show. When I got sick in 04, I did, because, my God, it was like a mystery disease, and Dr. Darvish did save my life. But I went on a journey to try to understand things that I had not understood. But what did you two get into this? What was it that you saw? I know we're going to show people a lot of stuff today, right?
Well,
but what was it that was like, dude, this can't be for real, right?
Well, initially, several years ago, when I was working as a caretaker for a gentleman that had Stage 4 renal cell cancer.
Wow.
I had actually met him the day that I met him. He had been told he had 6 months to live.
Wow.
He had been diagnosed 2 years prior and had been going through chemo and radiation, to which had no success for him.
Right.
So when I met him, you know, originally he wanted me to list all his tools and everything like that on an eBay site to part with, because he wasn't going to be here. So
sell the tools.
Right.
Right.
So,
oopsie.
But we had developed a friendship, and he said, you know what? There's one other avenue that I haven't pursued yet that some people have been telling me about. And I met this gentleman. He's a naturopath, and he says that I should start, you know, drinking alkaline ionized water.
Yeah.
And, you know, maybe look into a few different supplements, et cetera.
Yeah.
And I remember at the time thinking, oh, man, this. Weird, this guy's going to take advantage of that. I mean, I was really actually kind of a little bit irritated.
There you go.
I was.
That's it.
I was. But then Chris said, you know, I don't have anything else to lose. Why don't I try it? And I said, well, you know what? Why don't you try it then? At the time, I didn't ever ask or learn how or why, you know, water would be any different for him.
Right.
But we did follow
but
the protocol.
But you're like, you have nothing to lose.
You have nothing to lose. Yes.
Yeah, that's Janis Joplin.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah,
that's
totally,
right.
Freedom is another word for nothing left to lose,
that's
right?
Right.
Well, and true to my every word that I say here, Chris would go and he would get his scans done.
Yeah.
And every 3 months he'd get his scans done. And after the first 6 months, approaching the 9 month time, not only did he not have any new cancer growth in him, but the tumors that he'd had, the 9 that he'd had started to shrink in size. And I started thinking,
oh, well, maybe there is a little bit, you know, to this.
Maybe a little, right? You're like me.
Right.
Like, we're super skeptics.
Right.
Right. Well, I could probably count on one hand, really, how many times I've actually got behind something.
Well, and at the time, actually, the University of Washington was coming out with a new oral chemotherapy, today is called Sutent, but at the time it was an alphanumeric number.
Right.
And they had said to Chris, you know, when it's approved for you to be able to try, we want you to be able to come back because you're a great candidate for that. Well, by then, it had been a year and a half that Chris had been drinking the water, went back to the University of Washington, and they took a scan. They wanted to see where he was at because it was time for them to be able to give him the oral chemotherapy. And they said, whatever you're doing, keep doing it. You don't want what we were going to give you.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, he truly went from having 9 tumors in him to 6, and all of them being shrunk in size.
And
is he today?
He's great. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
So... burning question. Did he sell his tools?
He did not sell his tools. No, he had quite a bit of damage done to his back and stuff already.
But that's like, oopsie.
And you know, Patty, the amazing thing is, too, is that, you know, it's amazing that we know so little about water because, you know, Dr. Warburg in the 1930s won a Nobel Peace Prize for proving that disease cannot thrive in an alkaline environment.
Right.
But yet here we are. You know, 70, 80, 90 years later, and, you know, it's not talked about here. Now, this technology is used in every single hospital in Japan.
Mm-hmm.
It's in over 30,000 restaurants. And for the people out there that are washing their food, I'm going to do an amazing demonstration here in a little bit that's going to absolutely blow their mind about what comes off of food.
Oh, yeah.
And you'll see why this is used in every restaurant over there. But in America, this is not spoken of.
Yeah.
And it's a shame. It is.
Well, you know, when I was first introduced to this 10 years ago, I wasn't ready to, I wasn't at the place. I was really not well. And, you know, it's taken me a while to really get here and have this conversation. But I'll tell you, part of it was this. I recently lost a friend to cancer. And I wonder what would have happened if I'd have been a little bit more aggressive and assertive in, if nothing else, just saying, here's water.
And maybe open-minded.
And not everybody is open to this. Everybody's on their own journey. You know, I don't know if there's anything that I could have done, but if there's something that we can talk about today, especially for me, I'm a Lyme disease advocate, and I will tell you that we're going to talk about that today. We're going to talk about why things like this are important. For me, I decided to take a natural approach to healing. But Dr. Darvish will be the first one to tell you that it doesn't matter what approach you're taking. If your cells are not working, they are not working.
Correct. A healthy system starts with a healthy cell.
Very nice. That's a little quote.
Absolutely.
Karen. Good job. Let's take a short break, Mr. B. Why don't we do it? Pop it up there. And when we come back, we got some folks calling into the show. More from Dan, more from Karen. We're going to tell you a lot more about this. And I'm also going to share with you what is going to happen with this for us. We're going to tell you about what we're going to do, how we're going to do it, and why this is important to pay it forward. Stay tuned, everybody. We'll be right back.
The water is wide. I cannot cross over, and
there are so many resources out there for meditation, but did you know that Atana's Heart Earth Healing Meditation is available for you for free? Yes, that's right. You can receive this free healing meditation today from Atana Vadili. All you need to do is visit his website, atanamethod.com. That's A-T-A-A-N-A method.com, and sign up. You will receive your free meditation instantly. That's atanamethod.com.
Are you ready to stop stress, anxiety, and low self-esteem from running your life? Join award-winning author Dr. Friedemann Schaub for Empowerment Radio and learn breakthrough solutions to switch out of survival mode and approach every day with great ease, joy, and purpose. Tune in the first and third Wednesday at 11 a.m. Pacific to Empowerment Radio with host Dr. Friedemann Schaub on Transformation Talk Radio. Visit the fearandanxietysolution.com to learn more.
Are you tired of being bloated and nauseous? Hi, I'm Mary Jane Mack. Did you know eating unhealthy foods eventually leads to an unhealthy digestive system? Did you know eating the most healthy, nutritious food doesn't necessarily result in a healthy body? The stomach must be healthy in order to properly digest, metabolize, and utilize even the best of nutrition. Without proper digestion from the stomach through the intestinal tract, the nutritious value is not absorbed, and the improperly digested food can be more toxic to your body than helpful. You can be doing all the right things and getting all the wrong results. In fact, other organs may also be interfering with your stomach's ability to digest. Contact us today for your appointment at 888-777-4232. That's 888-777-4232. Or visit us at MaryJaneMack.com.
Hey everyone, this is Dr. Pat. I wanted to tell you about a new, powerful, and compelling play by Nicholas Vassili, coming to Seattle July 7th at Cornish Playhouse, Seattle Center, the United States of China.
On one hand, a dedicated American patriot who would give her life for her country. On the other hand, someone who has been battling the injustice and corruption of America most of her life. And she is as confused as any American could be about what she truly believes in. My play, The United States of China, is about the trial of Miriam Hopkins, who is a metaphor for all that America stands for.
This is more than a play experience. It's a movement. It's a movement to create a new level of awareness. Knowledge is power, and we are powerful. Get your tickets today at AmericaTheStrong.com.
Everybody, welcome back. It's so great to have all of you here. I am, this is really kind of cool because very rarely do I get to have in-studio stuff go on. And it's really kind of a little exciting when that happens. So today, for those of you that are watching the KKNW camera, you'll be able to see some of it. For those of you that are checking us out on the video we've created, you'll be able to watch this. And for those of you that are not, then what you'll be able to do is, listen. Because this is part of a bigger conversation, which we're getting ready to have. Dan, Karen, it's great to have you here. We got somebody listening as well, right? You guys want to introduce him?
Absolutely. This is a gentleman that we introduced the water to about a year ago, and his name is Ken Balzer. And are you there, Ken?
I'm here.
Okay, so maybe I'll let Patty take over.
Yeah, Ken, thank you. It's good to have you here. Now, what we're going to do is Dan's going to do a little demonstration, Ken, and you can jump in whenever you want, right? But
go
tell us what you're going to do, Dan.
Well, actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to demonstrate. Now, the water actually has three properties and many different uses for the machine. But what I'm going to show you now is a demonstration of the 11.5 water. I know a lot of your listeners out there, they say, well, I'm just drinking bottled water. The only thing I'm really doing at home, obviously, is washing my food.
Yeah.
And what I'm going to show you.
Well, that's what we think we're doing. But
absolutely.
We wash our food, we wash our hands, we wash our silverware, all of the above.
Right. So the machine has several properties.
What are you putting in there?
The machine actually splits the water to make an alkaline and an acidic water.
Okay.
So we have the 2.5. Which is a part of the machine that's actually 30 to 40
I used on my faucet.
Yep, we use it for sunspots, eczema, but it's actually an antibacterial. Mm-hmm. So it's about non-toxic, about 40 times stronger than bleach, but non-toxic.
Oh, sweet.
A byproduct of that is an 11.5, and why that is important to your listeners is what I'm going to demonstrate here.
Okay, so this, you just poured it right into the tomatoes.
Right, so what I'm doing is showing the mothers out there that are making a wonderful meal for their children. We've got tap water here.
Tap water is right there.
Right there.
Yep.
And then what we've done is with a push of a button and a lift of a lever, we've taken wonderful alkaline water, and this machine will make an 11.5. And I know that nobody's ever seen that done, but with this 11.5 will actually emulsify water. Okay? And what that means to your listeners is in the 70s, everything in America was truly organic.
Yeah.
And obviously after that, we started spraying a large amount of herbicides and pesticides, repellent, oil-based on all of our food.
Oh, yeah. There's a great scene from The Godfather, by the way, where in The Godfather, the Marlon Brando is with the little godchild, the boy.
Right.
And he's out in the backyard before he gets a heart attack, and he pulls out a can.
Right.
That can is what my grandfather used to we know that can, and he started to spray the tomatoes.
Sure.
And now that is a mini version of what we are doing today.
Right. Absolutely. And so what we're doing now to demonstrate this is we're just letting the various tomatoes soak for about 20 to 30 seconds, just kind of trying to simulate what somebody would be doing, washing off something in their sink, getting ready to make a salad.
Yep.
So as cleanly as possible, what we're going to try and do is here's the tap water, and everybody can see this on the
podcast.
Good job
on there, Dan.
Now you see that? Now that's perfectly clear water.
Yeah.
And that represents exactly what happens in everybody's sink at home. Okay?
Yeah.
This water, if we hold it up in the light, is perfectly clear the way that tap water
Looks
supposed
pretty
to
good
be,
to me.
Right?
Yep.
Okay.
Now, I even have my glasses on.
Now, here's what happens when you take our machine and run the water through that. Now, these are the same tomatoes. Now, look at that.
What is that?
Now, that is the oil-based products that are coming off of our food, and that's just representing a lot of what your family would go and eat.
That's yellow.
This is yellow.
It's all the herbicides and pesticides, the oil-based herbicides and pesticides.
Yeah, Ken, are you there?
I'm here.
What do you think of that?
Well, I think, Flint, Michigan has done us a great favor in recognizing that, people there are drinking bottled water. We won't even go down that road, but there are over 5,000 municipal water systems that should have been closed down and condemned yesterday. There's no alternative. Right now, the Seattle public school systems are not using their drinking fountains, are using bottled water. Portland's picked that up, and you're going to see that domino theory go right through that, through our country, very rapidly in the next 6 to 8 months. Mm. So what you're doing is an amazing revelation that people just don't know about.
Yeah.
And just as a footnote, the pH spectrum starts at 0 and goes to 14. 7 is neutral. You have to be below 2.6 to be acidic and above 11 to be alkaline. So that's why this technology gives you those extremes, which the body needs. And also, looking at those vegetables, I think you're looking at tomatoes there.
Yes.
That is a mind blower. People would not knowingly ingest that or have their children or family do that. So you guys are doing a great job.
Well, so tell us about your journey. What is it that brought you to the conversation?
Well, thank you. My background, I've always stayed active in my life. My daughter is a practicing physician for the last 17 years. I have an interest in a nutraceuticals company out of Montreal called Kiara Naturals, and I've worked with Bastyr and Naturopath. So I've looked for alternatives. And about 2 years ago, I was driving back from Clay Ellen, Washington, with a load of hay for my rescue horses. And keep in mind, I'm going 70 to 75 miles an hour at that point. I get off at Preston, and I'm going down Highway 203, about 30, 35 miles per hour, and I wake up in the hospital.
Wow.
I look around. My family's there, and I go, what's going on? And they go, Dad, you don't have a clue. I said, don't have a clue. I totaled a Dodge Dually 3500. Now, this is a rather large rig. I hit a tree, and I found myself in Evergreen Hospital. The short story is, for the next 9 months, I had every cardiology, neurological test known to mankind. Now, the benefit is, they said, you've got the heart of a 30-year-old, you're wired this way here, things are working out. And after 9 months of due diligence with specialists, they came up with the deductive reasoning that they said, Ken, we believe that you passed out from dehydration. Now, my first thought is I would have rather found something wrong with me that I could have corrected. Not really. But I go, how can I be dehydrated? That put me on a study to say, you know, I drink water. I do different things. I drink coffee, drink everything. How could I be dehydrated? So in my seven-month pursuit, when Dan and Karen introduced me to this technology, I'm going, this could be very, very important to my well-being and others. So I got the machine just under a year ago, and really, I'm kind of a skeptic, so I had to go to my sources that are naturopaths.
Yeah, me too.
And go, you know, I need to know this before I would share this with anyone. And my doctors, allopathic or naturopathic, when you get into a conversation with them, they say, Ken, we don't have any education on this. Nobody's taught us about this. We know nothing about it. So the technology has only come here in the last 10 to 12 years from Japan, where it's been a part of the medical community and very, very commonplace in Japan for 40-some years. So my immediate study was, how could this be happening? Is there a deeper issue here? And the more I pursued it, the more I found. I committed myself to this mission January 1st of this year after all my research and studies. So I believe this has helped me out immensely. I'll be 70 years old this next January. I stay very active. I have no pain. I wake up, jump out of bed. Dan and Karen know what my habits are. And thank goodness I have no consciousness of age because I don't feel 69 years old. Mm. I'll leave you on a thought. A water doctor that has become known as a water doctor is what is called Dr. Batmanjil. And I'm probably blowing the...
don't worry. I do it all the time.
But he has two books, and I want to pass this on to you and your listeners.
Yeah.
One is You're Not Sick, You're Thirsty. Mm-hmm. One wonderful book. The other one, Your Body's Many Cries for Water.
Excellent books.
Yeah.
The last comment I'll make is I found that as we mature, and I'm cautious not to use the word age, our alert system for thirst goes dormant at a time where we need it the most. That's true. If you go to places like Phoenix, Scottsdale, other locations where there's a concentration of retired people, you look up in the sky and see 5 to 7 medevac helicopters hovering at all times because they're picking up people to take to the emergency ward that have dropped over walking, talking on the golf course, whatever. So dehydration is the root of so many diseases, and that realism is just now coming through the medical community. So I'll turn it back to you guys.
Hey, thanks for joining us, Ken.
Yeah, hang on, Ken, if you don't mind. Just hang on for a few minutes. But, I mean, what we're talking about is, you know, yes, of course, water. But, you know, there's something really interesting that I want to just address real quick. And we're going to go into the next hour and continue it. You know, I think our bodies are smart. And so people are really mind-boggled about why we're not drinking more water. Well, what if our bodies knew that every time we pour a glass of water from the tap, it really was not the thing we should be putting in our body? I mean, it's really interesting to have so many people be so thirsty and not do the obvious. And almost everyone you says, I don't like water. I don't like to drink water. And there may be a very good reason why we don't, right? Sure. I mean, we know and can taste what that is that's coming out of the taps. I grew up on the East Coast, and, you know, I can't even tell you what they had to go through to just, you know, get the water so you could drink it. But the message here today is really about wellness. You know, Ken, I want to ask you a question. Do you know or how you physically have changed the way you feel since you started drinking the water?
Further tests. By cardiologist and neurologist, and a couple of heart medications I've been able to back off on, and the only change in my regimen has been the water.
Wow.
I would safely say after the first month or two, I started feeling more alert, more awake. Endurance has gone up. I sleep better. I find my weight has regulated itself with no change at all. We typically find that in the first 30 to 45 days, people will lose 4 to 12 pounds with absolutely no change in diet or activity due to toxicity release. Now, that's an amazing statistic. And I know there's a lot of people that are concerned about their weight management. And if you have the right hydration, it almost starts taking care of itself. Mm-hmm. So most people don't realize that the brain is 95% water. Blood is 90% water. When you go down that spectrum, it would make sense that not only the amount that you're taking, but the quality would have a significant impact.
Yes.
And it does. Absolutely. There is no question about that. I believe to reference your earlier question of why don't people drink more water? It's because of two very important things, I believe, Pat. One is people with busy lives, they take water for granted. They're assuming that the government, the state, the county would take care of their wellness as far as standards of purity, lacking toxins. And the absolute opposite is true. Over the last 20 years, the EPA and other water supposedly monitors have lowered the standards repetitively for municipalities, tap water, and bottled water industry to the point right now where there's over 280 pathogens in our drinking water, with studies, medical studies, double-blind studies, clinical trials to say most of these are carcinogenic. So people don't want to know that something so simple as water is so significant. Now, I will mention one thing and turn it back. Most people are not in the regimen or habit of drinking the proper amount of water because most people don't have a clue. Here's the rule of thumb. The minimum, if you get out of bed and go to your TV and do no other activity, you need 50% of your body weight in ounces all day long. Now, most people aren't even approaching that. Now, if there's anything chronic, acute, or you're active, I don't care if it's Pilates, yoga, working out at the gym, you need someplace between 60 and 75% of your body weight in ounces. And that is a behavior modification that has to be one that a person commits to.
Yeah, but let me just say this, because here's the deal. Dan gave me a machine to use, right? Because, you know, I'm the skeptic. And so when I had the machine, I was drinking the water and I wanted to drink the water. Now that the machine is not there anymore, I'm not drinking water. I'm not drinking it from the faucet. I have no intention because I think that we are people that are drawn to things we like. And if we don't like it, we don't do it. We don't eat it. We don't drink it. And I think the body knows that. Now, I pass my faucet on the average of pretty much any day, I pass that faucet on average 20 times. I can tell you that since the machine has been gone, my heart is a little broken. But since the machine left me, I know that I have not even stopped to turn on that faucet. That is an interesting dynamic. I'm going to probably have to go to therapy about that. But let's do this. We're going to continue in the next hour. Ken, don't hang up. What's a phone number people can call? And you guys can email me directly. And when we come back, I'm going to tell you what's going to happen with this for us. info@thedrpatshow.com. But what's a phone number that we can give out people that want to find out more?
They can call me at 206-769-0692. Obviously, we have
one more time.
206-769-0692. We have a tremendous amount of information we can share with them by video, by email, and obviously would love to help anybody.
Yeah, and we're going to talk more about it here coming up. Let's take a short break, everyone. We'll be right back.
The preceding audio was via a Skype call.